Okay, everyone, are you ready for part four of the RIFFS video series? The RIFFS that give me the biggest chills. I'm excited. This one was really tough. The drumming, some of the RIFFS were a challenge. And I realized halfway through that my kick drum pedals were set wrong. So every time I played double bass, it always sounded off and felt off to me. It even got to the point where I got so frustrated, I like spazzed out. Check it out. So after doing the drum tracks probably 8 times now altogether, finally was able to play them because I fixed the kick drums. Everything's good now. And here we go. Let's see what happens. All right, I got to see these guys live at First Avenue. It was a great show. And they put out this song, and then they did a Neil Diamond cover, and then they kind of disappeared. But I always love this riff. Okay, my teenage metal band played this at the junior high talent show, and people were freaking out, headbanging, and then we played it at a church function, a talent show, a couple weeks later, I think, and people were throwing chairs. It got pretty wild, but I think we knew we were on the right track when that happened. There was a time in my life when I was really young, and this was the heaviest riff I heard up until that time. So let's check it out. This might sound pretty interesting with a metal tone, but I remember watching Rocky III as a kid, getting so inspired. Leaving the theater thinking I could beat up anybody, you know, that feeling. But this riff was a big part of it. It's a classic, everyone knows it. It's a good riff to work out to. I wonder if anyone's heard of the band Jimmy's Chicken Shack. I always thought that name didn't really represent them too well because they were so cool, but I feel like maybe their name, people didn't take them seriously enough because of it, possibly. Anyway, they had a couple really great songs that I remember, and check them out if you can. They're, I think, from the early 90s. This is such a killer riff. I think this one gives me the biggest chills of all the riffs that give me the biggest chills. Now for something completely different. All right, here's a classic. You have to play the art of shredding on the art of guitar. That's just how it works. It was weird to see Anthrax change singers back then, but they took on this new kind of tougher sound, which I sort of liked at the time, but I was glad when Joey came back. This next one might seem like a strange choice, but when I heard it played live on some video when I was younger, it just hit me in a certain way that the album version really doesn't, but check out the live version if possible. So there was a time when Ministry and Nine Inch Nails were kind of competing for the top spot. And Nine Inch Nails just sort of took off, but Ministry always had a bunch of great riffs and songs, and this is one of them. I used to play this next riff so wrong. I did the easy version. I did Then I saw Vernon Reed play it on a YouTube video. Check that out. It's really cool how he teaches it. And I'm like, man, this riff's a lot harder than I thought. Got to see the Rev play this live before he passed away. Always be grateful for that. Check it out. Alright, I just put out a video about my old teenage band playing this song. Old teenage band, that's funny. And a lot of people responded that they liked the main riff, so here we go. It still gives me chills to this day. Sometimes I don't think Skid Row gets the credit they deserve for being as heavy as they were at the time. A lot of people called them rock, but I would say they kind of blurred the line between hard rock and metal sometimes, especially with a riff like that. Alright, we got a chance to open for Nuclear Assault way back in the day, and it was a huge dream, and I remember this album had just come out, and it has one of the coolest riffs ever. Heard this one, it just came out back in the day, and it still affects me the same way to this day. Got a chance to play with Weezer on stage once. Sort of won this contest and got to play three songs with them, so it was pretty cool. This was not one of them, but I've always loved this transition, especially the drum fill. Alright, this is one of the all-time great riffs, and it's actually pretty fun and interesting to play. I have to change my technique for this because of this really weird stretch that you're gonna see. Green Day just kind of exploded on the scene. I think it was 94 or so, I'm just guessing. But this was a hot riff. It always reminded me a bit of Kiss. If you listen to Detroit Rock City, it's kind of the same groove here. People used to come into the CD store and say, "Who sings that song, Heaven Let Your Light Shine Down?" And it was Shine by Collective Soul. But this riff always stood out to me as being really heavy compared to the rest of the song. And a little side note, I found out later that it's done with a drum machine. That's why it sounds a little bit strange. So go listen to it. You'll be like, oh yeah, it is a drum machine. Weird. This next riff almost didn't make the list. I thought of it last night, so it's kind of a last minute addition. But I love this riff. I love how heavy Live got for this one. It still is one of my favorite riffs. Okay, save this riff for last because it's the heaviest. It has drop C tuning, but it's by a local super heavy band back in the day called Disembodied, and this riff just kicks my butt. Okay guys, I have like 10 seconds. I just wanted to say thanks for watching. That was a lot of fun like always, and we'll catch you at the next video. My cameras are running out. 3, 2, 1.